If you've watched my videos building websites, you've probably seen that I use the rem unit for all my font sizes. And I get asked pretty often why I use rems instead of pixels.
What?
Well, there's a really good reason for this: accessibility. What this means is that some users may need to make the text on a website bigger in order to read it more easily. They can do this by changing their browser base font size in their browser settings. There's a lot more to accessibility than font size, but this is one aspect of it that we'll be looking at today. But before we get started, I wanted to give a big thank you to my YouTube members, specifically Paul Maximus and Salman Hersey. If you want to support this channel, you can click the join button in any video and get some cool perks. All right, let's get into it. All right, so I have a pretty simple website here with an H1 tag for the headline, and then I have some more text underneath in a paragraph tag. So let's first look at how to change your browser's base font size. I'm using Firefox, but basically any browser is going to have this in their settings. So if you open the settings, we can see here that there's something saying fonts and colors, and it's telling us that the default font is Times New Roman and it is set at size 16. So this means 16 pixels. 16 pixels is going to be the default font size for most browsers. So let's say we want to make the text bigger so that we can read it better. I'm going to change 16 to, let's say, 32, so it's going to be double. And I've changed that. And now we can see on the website the text is much bigger. It's basically twice the size. So let me just change it back to 16. And let's look in the code for this. So in VS Code, I have the index.html for that website we just saw open here. And we have the H1 tag. And then we have that paragraph tag underneath it. And then the styles that are controlling the text size are in typography.scss. So the H1 tag, we have the font size set to 2 rems, or 32 pixels for mobile, and then 4 rems, or 64 pixels for desktop. So what this means is that because of our base font size is set to default 16 pixels, that means that 1 rem is equal to 16 pixels. So 2 rems is 16 times 2, which is 32. 4 rems is 16 times 4, which is 64. So we can see this in action. So if we inspect the headline, we have that selected and we can see that the H1 has a font size set to 4 rems. Now, if we go to the computed tab, it's telling us that the final font size in pixels is 64 pixels, which is exactly what we have set in our styles. So now let's go back to our settings again. And then once again, we're going to change the base font size in our browser to 32. So this is doubling all of our text size. And we can see the text got a lot bigger. And now if we look at the H1 tag styles, it's telling us that the font size is now 128 pixels. So it's 2 times 64, 128. So let's just go back and change this. So the reason that the text size is changing in our browser is because the rem unit is dependent on the browser-based font size, like we mentioned. But what happens if we have our styles for font size set in pixels instead of rems like we do? So let's go back to our code. And for the H1 tag, I'm going to comment out the 2 rems. I'm going to replace it with 32 pixels. And these should be the same, right? Because 1 rem is 16 pixels times 2 is 32 pixels. And then we'll make this 64 pixels and comment out the 4 rems. So we'll save that. And if we go back to our website and go to our website settings, now let's once again change the size in our browser to 32. And let's see what happens. Okay, so we can see that the headline text sort of stayed the same. If we inspect it, let's refresh that. It's at 64 pixels, which is what we had before. But the paragraph tag text did get bigger because that is still set in rems. It's set to 1.5 rems. So the reason that the headline text is kind of stuck at 64 pixels, even though we increased the base font size in the browser settings, is because pixels are what we call an absolute unit. And they don't change at all if the base font size is changed. They're always going to be, you know, 64 pixels, that's never going to change. And this is not good for accessibility, as you might imagine, because if a user is changing their base font size settings, they want the text to become bigger, and it's not going to get bigger if you have the size set in pixels. So generally, it's not considered good practice to use pixels as your unit, especially for font size. Now, you might be wondering, you know, why can't users just zoom in instead? So let's look at that. So let me first change this back to 16, just to get everything back to normal. So everything's back to normal. So now, instead of changing the base font size, let's zoom in instead. And I'm actually going to go to the mobile styles to look at that. And right now it's set to 32 pixels. So let's zoom in to 200%. So now it looks like the H1 tag is zoomed in, and also the paragraph tag got bigger as well. Oops, wrong window. So we can see that zooming in does actually make the text bigger. And this is because when you're zooming in, you're basically making the pixels, you know, zoom in. So everything's getting bigger, even if you have it set in pixels. However, the zoom function is something, it's kind of a newer feature in browsers. Before zoom was really a big thing in browsers, the base font size was the only way you could really change the text size. So even though zoom does work, I think because we still have the browser-based font size in our settings, I think it's best that we allow users to be able to control the font size using that, since it still exists. So we mentioned that pixels are absolute units, meaning they don't change relative to anything else. 16 pixels is always going to be 16 pixels, no matter what. And rems are a relative unit because they are based on something else. They're based on the browser base font size. And you may have also heard of MEM units, which are sort of similar to rems, but they're a little bit different. And as a quick bit of history trivia, you might be wondering, you know, where the heck did the name M and rem come from? Like, do they stand for something? Well, they're actually not acronyms, really. The MEM gets its name from way back in the day when, you know, type involved using metal blocks and printing presses and things like that. And one M unit was traditionally defined as the width of the capital letter M for the typeface and the type size. Nowadays, of course, M and rem units aren't based on the size of the letter M, but they're still dependent on something else, which is why they're called relative units. So about the M unit, M units are different from rems in that they're based on the font size of their parent element. So let me show you what I mean. So let's go back to desktop mode here. And let's go into our code. So in my code, I'm going to change the H1 font size to 2 M's instead of 2 rems like we had originally. And then for desktop, I'll change it to 4 M's. Instead of 4 rems. And if we go back to the website, everything looks fine. However, what if we set a different font size on the parent element of this H1 tag? So we can see here in our inspector, the H1 tag is a child element of the main tag. So I'm just gonna make this change here, but for the main selector, what if we set the font size to something else? So let's say font size 0.5 rems, which is equal to 8 pixels, since 1 rem is 16, half of that is 8 pixels. So you might have seen the H1 tag got smaller. So if I uncheck it, this is the normal size that we want, and now it's like half the size. And if we go to the H1 tag and we look at the computed tab, it says 4 m's for font size. Computed, it is 32 pixels instead of 64 like it was before. So the reason for this is because when you're using M's, one M gets set to whatever the parent font size is. So the H1 tag, which is set to 4 M's, it's basing itself off of the font size of the main tag, which is 0.5 rems, which means one M on the H1 tag is equal to 8 pixels. And since it's set to 4 M's, 4 times 8 is 32, which is why the computed final font size of the H1 tag is set to 32 pixels. Now, you might be thinking this is kind of complicated, and I actually agree with you. This kind of weird multiplier effect is not something that I really want to work with. And, you know, if you work with M's, you might have some unexpected results like this here. The headline text is much smaller than we would have expected. So this is one reason why I personally like using rems, not m's, even though m's are a relative unit and they're accessible. So if you want to use m's, you're more than welcome to, but my personal preference is to use rems. So I'm actually going to go back to rems for these. And then now we're back to the sizes that we wanted for the H1 tag, 64 pixels. Now there is one thing you might have noticed in my code, that my media queries are written in ems. But didn't I just say I don't like using ems? That's true. Media query breakpoints are the only place that I use em units. And the reason for this is because I read an article, which I'll show you, by Zell Liu. He wrote an article saying that for media queries, the best unit to use is actually the em, because if you use rems, there is some kind of Safari bug that makes it not trigger at the right time. So I don't know if that's still the case, if you're aware of this bug, and if you know it's been fixed, I guess let me know in the comments. But just based on this article, I just use ems in my media queries, and it's basically the same. And you know that it's always going to be based on the browser-based font size, because there's no, you know, parent element or whatever for the media query. Okay, so how do we use rems, and what's the easiest way to do that? It is a little bit tricky with the math, because if you've watched any of my previous or older sort of live coding videos, you may have noticed that I would like always pull out my calculator and have to multiply or divide things by 16 to get between pixels and rems. And it is kind of a pain. In the past, there was this sort of hacky workaround where you would set your font size in the root, in the HTML element, to, instead of 100%, you'd set it to 62.5%. And what that is I will pull out the calculator here, but it's 62.5% of the base font size from your browser. So that's 16 pixels, the default in the browser, times 0.625, and that equals 10. So doing this will make one rem equal to 10 pixels. And it's a lot easier to do math based on 10. So if we go back to our typography.scss file, instead of having to do math and be like, oh, I want this to be 32 pixels, but how do I get that? I divide it by 16 to get the two rems. Instead, you want 32 pixels. So what you can do is just say 3.2 rems. You're dividing 32 pixels by 10 to get 3.2 rems. In the same way, you can do this with 64 pixels, will be 6.4 rems. And this is all because of the 62.5% that we set on our root. So let's see how that looks in our website. Okay, things look really different. I didn't change the paragraph tag, so let's just go back and do that really quick. So paragraph, we want to be 24 pixels, so I'm gonna say 2.4 rems. And now things should look back to normal, right? So now in the H1 tag, we can see that it is 64 pixels, and in the rules, it's 6.4 rems. So this is working. However, this was kind of a workaround that came about, you know, when you were still using straight up pure CSS files. Nowadays with Sass, I use a different approach, and let me show you that now. So let's first change everything back. 1.5 rems, 4 and 2 rems, and then I will remove this and make it back to 100%. So what I use is I use a Sass function. So I have this in my functions.scss file. I got this off of CSS Tricks. As you can see, I put a little comment there. But what this is doing is it's creating a function, rem, and the rem function can take one parameter. And in the parentheses, you just put the number in pixels that you want the final font to be. And I didn't use that earlier because, you know, I just wanted to show you directly what the actual rem styles would be. But let's say we didn't have that, and we want the font size to be 32 pixels, but we don't want to have to calculate to rems. So rem function 32. And then in the same way, we can do this. Instead of having to calculate what 64 pixels to rems is, we can use rem and then 64. And I'll do the same thing for the paragraph tag. We'll say rem 24. So we'll save that and go back to our website, and it looks pretty good, right? So H1 tag, it's set to 4 rems because when we compile the Sass to CSS, it will calculate and put the final value in rems for you. And it's at 64 pixels. And then if we check the paragraph, it is 1.5 rems. And then that computes to 24 pixels. So personally, I like using this rem function over the 62.5%. sort of hack, I guess. I don't want to like negate it or whatever, because I do think it is very handy if you don't want to, you know, use a whole Sass function or you're working in pure CSS. But this is, you know, just my preference. So I figured I would share that with you all here. So I hope this video helps clear up, you know, why I use rems and why you really shouldn't be using pixels in your styles, especially for font sizes. If you are interested in hearing more about Sass, you might like my video that I made recently about how to use the new use and forward rules with the new Sass syntax. And you can also check out how I set up my Sass workflow in a real-world website project. So if this video helped you, feel free to leave a comment and also consider joining my YouTube members if you're interested in that. You'll get perks like a custom icon next to all your comments or even in the live chat when I do premieres. And I also have an early access tier where you get to see new videos before they get released to the general public. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.